Hi guys, what is up and welcome to the Theatre Lounge. Welcome to everyone who's been here before, and a massive welcome to everyone who's here for the first time. Here at the Theatre Lounge, I talk about everything to do with theatre because I love this industry so much, but I also give my top tips when it comes to auditions, cottages, and everything else that comes with it. I upload videos twice a week, every Tuesday and every Friday, so if you haven't yet, make sure that you hit that subscribe button to keep updated with all my theatre content. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about my top 10 musical theatre characters, who are my favourites and why and the reasons behind it and all of that. Also, I've got a couple of announcements to make, so make sure that you keep watching because I'll be mentioning them later on in this video. But now, without further ado, let's take it onto the list. Quick side note before we actually start, this is a randomised list. These are not in a particular order just yet, just my top 10 characters. Right, cue the list. Right, so the first character that I'm going to be talking about is Violet from Violet. I find this character to be very, very impressive. When I saw this musical in London, I was amazed by Violet, the character herself. I feel like Violet goes through so much during the show and shows all of her characteristics. Any actress who plays this character, I like kudos to them because it takes so much to get involved within the character because it's such a big character, I feel. Like knowing about Violet, how she's got all her standards and everything, and then she gets like estranged from that. Is that even a word? Yeah, she gets like pulled away from herself, but she still stays within herself. Like, it's a mastermind of a character, and well done to Janita Sorley who wrote this character as well, because yeah, the songs, everything that Violet does like enhances the character, and that is how it should be. Right, for my second one, I'm going to be talking about a Phantom from The Phantom of the Opera. So personally, I am a sucker for female characters for some reason, but I could not mention the Phantom because I feel like the Phantom's got such a presence. When he gets onto the stage, like, he pulls all the focus, and obviously, like, that, I know that's how it should be because the show is technically about him, but the attention to detail in the character and like how we're able to see the good side of the Phantom as well, I think is a brilliant character. Obviously, I love every single song that he sings. I mean, who doesn't? But I think that that is my favourite thing about the Phantom, that although he's like such a presence and could be such a scary character, there's such a likability to him. Don't get me wrong, because I know I said I love female characters usually, and I've mentioned the Phantom. I love Christine a lot, but when I saw the Phantom on stage, I was like, what? Right, let's carry on. Another character that I really do like is Margaret from Everybody's Talking About Jamie, who plays the mum. I think that character embodies motherhood in a way. Kind of how much she loves her son and she'll do anything for him. And obviously, like, you see how teenagers like clash with their parents and all of that. And I think that show symbolizes that really well. And I feel like within Margaret, you see everything a mum is. Even just listening to the soundtrack and on watching the actual show, I feel like you get to know Margaret, and I think that's a really good thing. But I also like the fact that we don't just see Margaret with Jamie, we see Margaret's life as well. Like, her friends and everything, and what she goes through in life as well, and what she did. So like, I just could carry on about Margaret. I think it's such a beautiful character. It's so well-rounded. Obviously, I know it's built on a real person, so that obviously is gonna help a lot. But yeah, I just feel like it is well-rounded. There's a full backstory to it, and that shows. Right, for my next character, I'm gonna be speaking about Peter from Bear, a pop opera, or Bear the Musical. I feel like Peter is a character that is so relatable to so many people, and I feel like this musical needs to get more love. I actually mentioned it in my underrated musicals. This musical needs to be a bit more known because of what it stands for. The struggles that Peter goes through, a lot of people go through them. I personally went through some of the struggles that Peter goes through during the show, and having that musical there that I could listen to and feel like I could relate to someone and that I'm not going through this by myself. Yeah, that's my main reason why I think this show needs to get more love. But yeah, Peter in general is a very relatable character, and that shines through. His songs are also so real and everything, and I just feel like you've got a friend within Peter if you're going through something like that. And Peter also shows the difficulties that he's going through, like finding himself and being gay in a church school. But yeah, I've said it way too many times. I do love Peter, and I do love this character because I think he's very relatable and you can find a friend within him. Now, someone totally different to what I've just been talking about is Kim from Miss Saigon. Kim goes through such a journey in the show. It's quite crazy, to be honest. Like, where the show starts and where the show ends, Kim literally like shows an entire life, basically how she falls in love and how she has a child and she wants to do anything for that child. If you don't know the show that much, careful, because this is a spoiler alert, but in the end Kim actually shoots herself to save her child, and hopefully her child can have like a better life. And I don't think there's many shows that actually do that, like show such a thing. Yeah, I just think that the journey of Kim is massive, it's beautiful. All her songs are absolutely incredible as well, can we just say that? So Andrew just came in and got me this, bless him. Oh, he's lush. Oh, that's lush. Right, so for my next one, I actually got two characters in one because I think they have to go together. And these are Elphaba and Glinda from Wicked. From the beginning of the show, how like they get to school and everything, and till the end, they go on a massive journey. Obviously, we all know that in the beginning, they kind of hate each other and then they become friends later on in the show. And although like the show is revolving around Elphaba mainly, I feel like Glinda is such a massive part of the show, obviously, because she helps Glinda get to where she is in a way. But yeah, I absolutely love Elphaba and Glinda. I think they're really well-written characters as well. Obviously, they've got like a backstory in a way because they've been in so many other like shows and books and stories and movies and everything, so there is a massive character to them. But I think one of the reasons that I love these characters so much is because of the original casting. I think Idina Menzel and Kristen Chenoweth like created such a great bond between the characters. I think it takes quite a lot for every actor to get what they've achieved in a way. But yeah, they're brilliant characters, brilliant songs, obviously. I mean, I personally love What Is This Feeling. I just find it really funny. And then obviously I know that they've got every other song where they show off their voices, and I just think they're beautiful, you know? So quick side note before I carry on with the list. I've created a new Facebook group called Theatre YouTubers and Bloggers. So basically, I'm trying to create a community where we all help each other out, we all support each other, because this industry obviously right now is going through tough times, and I think this is a very good way of supporting each other and making sure that, yeah, we're helping each other out. So if you yourself are a theatre YouTuber or a theatre blogger, make sure that you join the group. I will link it down below as well. It's called Theatre YouTubers and Bloggers, and let's support each other, let's help each other out. Right, so for my next character, I'm going to be talking about Charlie from Kinky Boots. I personally love Kinky Boots. I think it's a great show and what it stands for. I really appreciate that. Yeah, I feel like Charlie's an amazing character because there's determination within him, there's a fire within him to get him to where he wants to be. And he's also one of the few characters I feel that doesn't judge a book by its cover in a way. Yeah, I just really love the fact of how he accepts, obviously, Lola and all of that. I feel like people need to be more like that in the world, and it's such a great platform to have someone like that, such a character like that, to be shown to other people. Right, let's move on to my next one, and my next character is Eliza from My Fair Lady. I personally find Eliza very, very funny. Everything she says is absolutely hilarious, I find her. I don't know why, but then I think she flips it halfway through, and she kind of takes over Higgins in such a great way. Yeah, I just feel like it's really good. I just feel like it's amazing what she can do and how she does it. And that again, is shown on stage. Also, when this musical actually premiered and everything, it was such a great moment to have that on stage, because obviously all that was happening in the world with feminism and everything, I just feel like it is such a great way of showing that on stage. As I said with Charlie from Kinky Boots, I feel like Eliza, like, is such an embodied character that is so good to be on this platform because it can reach more people and send the message out even further. Yeah, I just love how true the character is and how also, like, how she wins the situation at the end and she wins over Higgins. Right, and now for my final character, I'm going to be talking about Maisie from Suzical, Maisie Lovebird. I personally love this show. I actually did it when I was in college. And I loved the character Maisie. I just think, first of all, it's sassy, and who doesn't love a sassy bird? Random, isn't it? But it works. Again, she's a very funny character, I feel, and everything she says is quite funny. But then again, we see a different side to Maisie that I really enjoyed watching in the show. I loved seeing how she changed within the show, how she went from all this sassiness and like loving life and I'm going on holiday and all of that, to then obviously being like, oh, I don't want this, like, I've done something wrong and I can't handle it, basically. But yeah, I just think, again, it's a different character that is showing something different that people can relate to. I mean, I absolutely love the song Amazing Maisie. I just think it's funny. I think it fits in the show really well, and it's really funny as well. And yeah, I love Maisie. I love everything from Susie Kill, to be honest, because I feel like Susie Kill is such a great show that doesn't get a lot of love as well. It just brings all the stories from your childhood to life and onto the stage, and I think it's great. But there we go, there we have it. That is my top 10 characters from musicals. Let me know what yours are. Let me know in the comments below. I would love to know and go through them all and maybe find some new characters to love as well. Remember to follow me on my social media to keep updated and get your daily dose of musical theater. I will link all the links below. Also, if you want to become a part of my Facebook group, make sure that you just join. I will link that below as well. It's a public group, so anyone can join. Just let's have fun and support each other out. I do hope you've enjoyed today's video. Let me know what other videos you want to see. But if you've enjoyed this one, make sure you give it a thumbs up. That'll give it a like. And also subscribe to my channel for more theatre content. Thank you guys for joining me, and I will see you all on Friday. Bye, guys.